Hi, my name's Umesh, or Umi Venkatesan. I'm an institute scientist at Moss Rehabilitation Research Institute, and I'm the director of the Brain Trauma and Behavior Laboratory. I'm trained as a clinical psychologist and neuropsychologist, so my general area of research is cognition and mental health in traumatic brain injury, or TBI. I have a special interest in the long-term effects of traumatic brain injury, especially what happens to people with TBI as they age. Now, we know what happens in the short term. People do recover some cognitive function, but we know much less about what happens as people face the normal age-related challenges that we'll all ultimately face. So some of the questions are, how do we track these people? How do we know if they're staying stable or if they're showing some signs of cognitive decline? So one of the current projects that we have going on pertains to memory. As people age, they often complain of memory problems, and this is also one of the number one complaints of people with traumatic brain injury. All our memory tests are good for sort of getting gross impairment, but we really can't tap into the everyday memory problems that people are having. They don't really map on that well. So one of our questions is, how can we design memory studies to better tap into some of the real-world problems that people are having? So one of the goals of this project is to bridge that lab-life divide, to create memory assessments that are more sensitive to the problems that people are facing. And if we get at the more subtle difficulties that people are facing, we might be able to tailor interventions to them better. So the primary methodology that we're using for this initial study is neuropsychological testing. And that includes oral tests, paper and pencil tests, and some computerized tests as well. And what we're trying to do is get at more subtle memory decline. So we're modifying some of these testing procedures. For example, testing memory a week out rather than just looking at how people perform in a single visit. And when we compare those two, we might be able to get a sense of their sort of longer term overall memory picture. We're also using a lot of different types of stimuli like words, pictures, associations, stories, because we want to see which memory format works best. We also want to see different factors that contribute to better or worse memory performance. And we get at this by analyzing patterns of cognitive performance objectively, but we also use structured questionnaires that are very important in trying to get at the other variables that are involved in memory functioning. If we give clinicians the tools to better assess memory and to better assess all sorts of cognitive functioning that are more applicable to everyday life, then they can design more personalized interventions and, importantly, be able to assess the impact of those personalized interventions on patient care and their lives. And in the long term, we can enable clinicians to track these people and to identify people who might be at risk in the very early stages of cognitive decline before something major happens to them and they're really suffering from some functional challenges.